I gotta ask the obvious question. Three wives, seven kids. How are you gonna be the expert on relationships and helping kids out? What's up with that?
Because it's obvious that I have the skill set to convince anybody to do anything. So I took advantage of it, you know.
How can you change a child who felt a loss because their father wasn't in the family?
What's really important for people to realize, when you make mistakes and you recover from them and you treat the mistakes as valuable learned experiences, then you've got something to share. You don't have a dad in your life, okay? We take that excuse from them on the first day. Mentoring isn't money. We need people who have time. A boy needs your time, he don't need your money. And if you got time, you can mentor.
Ivanka, I've known you since you were a little girl modeling back.
Very little, yeah.
You grew up with a very stylish mother. She's wonderful. I mean, I love your mom. I've spent a lot of time with her.
I learned growing up so much from my mother, and so much in a way that's translated to me on a personal level, but also on a professional one. My parents were very conscious of instilling in us a sense of gratitude, but also a lack of entitlement.
Talk about Girl Up.
Girl Ups really tries to help adolescent girls around the world who are in challenging situations. I'm just amazed by what they're doing.
What's so fascinating about you guys, your fiance Dax, they're not gonna get married until it's legal for everyone to get married.
People say like, wow, you're really doing that. And I'm like, well, yeah, are you kidding? Like, my friends can't get married. When am I gonna have a wedding and invite 50% of the people that can't celebrate this, right? I mean, this is the wrong side of history. It is like throwing a party at the front of the bus in the 60s and all your friends are black.
I gotta give you a high five on that one. That is great. How did you start the foundation?
We said, let's take these kids and show them the world and show them they can be anything they want to be.
It's so interesting because people think, I don't have any money, I can't help.
It's not true. If you see something going on that causes you great anger or makes you so happy that you want to just kiss everybody, that means there's something you need to do.
You're one of the 8 biggest celebrity contributors to charity, right up there with Oprah and Tiger.
That's a good group.
That's a good group to be in.
The money that I raise for my foundation, I give it back into building rec center. I have a rec center in Baltimore right now. My goal is to, every couple years, to hopefully build a new rec center.
I'm Philip Locke, and today's Cause Celeb, it's the AIDS Walk New York City.
So many incredible people here today, and it's my first AIDS Walk.
Today, I'm walking for humankind with an emphasis on walking for the sisterhood.
Whenever I think of glamour, chic, I think of Christie Brinkley. Today, we're gonna find out some of the things that she's passionate about.
I was alarmed by the numbers, the breast cancer numbers out here, and so I worked to try to close nuclear reactors and try to help the people who are dealing with the effects of the daily onslaught of low-level radiation. There's no limit to love.
They once asked my parents when the nanny was at its height, did she speak different when she was a kid? And my mom, in like the exact same voice, said, we never knew she had a funny voice. I got famous, I got cancer, and I live to talk about it. And I'm talking and I'm helping people.
Susan Lucci, Erica Kane from All My Children.
America Kane.
She was kind of bitchy back in the day. You literally have changed people's lives.
We're facing AFib. You can see if you have an irregular heartbeat, which is really what AFib is, atrial fibrillation.
A few years ago, tragedy struck very close to home for you. Your best friend, one of your best friends, Krista Martinez, a friend of many, many years, was diagnosed with stage 4 breast cancer, and your aunt was at the same time. Kristen had a very important message that she wanted delivered, and you've been doing a good job of that. Why don't you tell us about that?
Yeah, she was just like, I'll put it in different language because, you know, Kristen was very real. She was like, fear can literally kill you, and you got to tell people it's better to know than to not know.
You're putting it out there in the universe. You are putting out there that I'm not going to take this, whether it's rape, whether it's breast cancer, a bad husband, you're not gonna take it, and we love it.
No, well, thank you.
Thank you. One of the statistics I thought was fascinating, that a woman dies every 90 seconds somewhere on the planet from complications after childbirth.
Of those deaths, 90% of them are preventable. The same complication that I experienced delivering a child in New York City in a birthing center in a hospital, I learned is the leading cause of maternal death in the world.
Tell us about the work that you're doing at Hope North.
There's really no point in having money or having notoriety whatsoever if you can't rush in and try to help fix something. My friend Susan Sarandon, we together put on a benefit last year. It was a lot of fun and we helped raise some money for the school.
Very intrigued by the story of Carolina and Lewis. Lewis was in a car accident when he was young.
Right. 17 years ago.
He became paralyzed, and I think it's great that you guys are supporting the Walkabout Foundation because we're so close with stem cell research to actually putting an end to paralyzation due to spinal cord injury.
Right, we're very, very close.
What's it like having a father that leads by example?
Well, I know that he's not full of it. I know that he walks the walk. I mean, this is a guy that goes where the cameras are not and gets arrested whether the cameras are there or not. Most times they're not.
And for the good of others, which is really the impressive thing.
Well, you do it for yourself because you cannot not do it and be yourself. That's my take on it.